Welcome to SBJ Spotlight. I'm Austin Karp. Joining me is the athletic director at San Diego State, J.D. Wicker. Thank you for taking the time to join us.
Absolutely. Appreciate the opportunity.
I want to talk quickly about your new venue, Snapdragon Stadium. It opened up, first football season in the books. What has that meant to the Aztec fan base, revenue for your school, and the football experience for the program?
Yeah, the stadium has been a huge hit in San Diego. I tell people the architects exceeded my expectations in creating a building that meets the needs for everyone. We sold out of our premium before the season started, and our premium seat holders have loved it. The experience, the food, the beverage has been great. We designed a lot of social spaces into the building, and those have been, you know, taken advantage of to the point sometimes people ask, where are all the people in the stadium because there's no one in their seats? It's because they're in the Northwest Scoreboard Bar along the East Concourse. So overall, it's been a huge hit. The revenue number is really big for us. We're definitely, you know, we've exceeded our pro forma in our sponsorship deals. Our per caps are higher than what we had put into our pro forma as well. So we're really pleased with what we did with, you know, with Aztec Athletics. And then, you know, we've got all the other events that will be coming into the building.
How important was getting that naming rights deal on the venue?
Naming rights was, you know, it was really a big one. And it was great that it was a local partner, Qualcomm with the Snapdragon brand coming in. And it was great not just because they're, you know, they're a national firm locally based in San Diego, but it was more than the stadium. They're, you know, they're interested in really working with the overall institution. A lot of our graduates in engineering go to Qualcomm and, you know, other areas of the campus. So they were really interested in a larger integration. So that's something we're going to be working on with the Innovation District that's just south of the stadium, and then the overall development.
You know, what are some other future uses you can see for the venue? Is it adding concerts? Is it potentially bringing a bowl game or even pro sports franchises into the venue?
Yeah, I mean, we're fortunate. We're in San Diego, and we specifically built the building to be multi-purpose. We've already got the NWSL, San Diego Wave FC, is a partner in the building. San Diego Legion, which is professional rugby. We've got 3 weekends of dirt shows in January. We just announced the Red Hot Chili Peppers in Pink. We'll be playing in the building. We've got a couple of significant soccer matches, men's soccer matches coming up next year that we look forward to announcing shortly. We're working on men's professional soccer in the building as well. So, and then we really designed it to be used on a day-to-day basis with those smaller events. All of our premium areas are designed, whether it's a sales conference, it's a wedding reception, it's a holiday party. The northeast corner of the building is designed to do a 1,000-person concert. You can pull in food trucks. We've got the hookups. So I looked at the stadium and I said I wanted to be busy 365 days a year, and that's what we're trying to do.
Well, the stadiums look fantastic on TV. I know we did a feature on it in Sports Business Journal. You know, Brett McCormick, our facilities writer, raves about it, and you know, I know we're going to continue to watch what you're doing at the venue. So, J.D. Wicker, San Diego State, thank you for joining us. For SBJ Spotlight, I'm Austin Karp.